Hey everyone, Grant here for the Flame Learning channel. In this video covering Batch Paint in Flame 2018, you'll learn how to create animated paint strokes. In previous versions of Flame, this was known as Auto Paint, and it was only available in the Desktop Paint module. In Flame 2018, this functionality has been implemented in Batch Paint, and it is slightly more flexible than the original Auto Paint feature. Other applications may refer to this functionality as stroke or write-on. If you'd like to follow along, all you need is a fresh batch group. In the batch node bin, drag out a fresh paint node into the batch schematic. You could attach a background input, as well as add source connections into the paint node if you're working on footage. But you can also just create a paint node like this and start working straight away. Double-click on the paint node for its controls, and press F4 if you don't see the paint result view. Now you're going to learn the workflow of creating animated brushstrokes, and this can be used in a variety of post applications. Think of animated writing, revealing mats, wire removal, and more. So we'll run through these controls that will enable you to do all that and more. Firstly, let's set up the brush. Change the paint range from current frame to sequence. We'll stay with the freeform type, and the color is set to white. Hold the S keyboard shortcut and size the brush on the canvas to around 30. As a quick reminder from the previous batch paint videos, most of the brush properties can be edited after creation. Now go ahead and draw a wavy stroke from one end of the frame to the other. If you don't get it right the first time, just press Ctrl-Z to undo and redo the stroke until you like it. Now this is one single stroke, and if you switch to the Edit menu, you can select it in the Strokes list. Only once it is selected can you edit its properties if required. To animate the selected paint stroke over time, switch to the Animation menu. Here you should see the highlighted stroke, and you can press Shift-Tab to focus and expand the selected channels. Now, in order to animate a brush stroke, there are two animation channels which give you a variety of options. They are called Start and End. This refers to the start of the stroke and the end of the stroke. At this point, my advice to you is to turn on Regen, so that you see the interactivity of the stroke as you create the animated curve. Now we'll work with each of these channels, and then combine them later on. We'll first start with the end channel, and this creates the traditional write-on or stroke animation. Enable Auto Key, and ensure you are on the first frame. Now these channels only work between 0 and 1, so set the end channel to a value of 0. Next, go to the last frame and set the end channel to 1. At this point, if you don't see the whole curve for the channel, click the Frame All button. Now go ahead and scrub the time bar. As you can see, the stroke paints itself on screen as you scrub from the beginning to end. And if you want the animation speed to be linear, click the Interpolation pull-down menu and change it from Bezier to Linear. So the end channel allows you to draw a stroke on screen. Please select the end channel and click the Reset Channel button. The other channel you have is the Start channel. This does the inverse of the end channel. In other words, your stroke can start on screen and paint itself off. So go to the first frame. With Auto Key still enabled, set a keyframe value of 0 in the Start channel. Go to the last frame and set a value of 1 in the Start channel. As before, you can change the interpolation to Linear. Turn Auto Key off for now. When you scrub the time bar, the stroke is on screen for the first frame and it paints itself off screen for the duration of the animation. So that's what these two channels can do when used separately. Now, we'll come back to these channels shortly, but there are a few extra details you need to know. Switch out of the animation menu and return back to the edit menu. Firstly, each stroke in the strokes list has the capability of being animated over time. So if you had 20 separate strokes, you would have to animate the start and end channels of each one separately. You could then offset their timings, etc. It can be useful for certain things, but it can also be quite cumbersome. So as an alternative, you would use the consolidate workflow to combine multiple strokes into one. Switch back to the paint mode, and under the canvas header, click the clear all button to remove any strokes in the paint node. This time, I'll set the pressure to constant and enable consolidate. Change the paint type to circle and draw a circle on the left. Next, switch the paint type to rectangle and draw a rectangle in the center of the canvas. Finally, switch back to freeform and make a squiggle from top to bottom. Turn off consolidate. When you switch to the edit menu, you have a single stroke which can be animated over time. You can also select it and position it accordingly. Go ahead and change the color for fun. Remember that you could also change the paint mode to anything, including reveal, clone, and even wash if you wanted. Now switch back to the animation editor and focus on the start and end channels. As before, enable Auto Key, and on the first frame, set the start keyframe value to 0. Go to the end of the composite and set the start value to 1. Change the interpolation to linear. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see how each stroke is animated one after the other on the canvas. Now this brings us to the third and final animated stroke workflow. You can combine the end and start channels to create short moving strokes. For instance, you could use this technique to composite highlight passes on titles. So go to frame 1, select the end channel, and set the keyframe value to 0.025. This is the short stroke for the first frame. Next, go to the last frame, and then step 2 frames backward. The end channel needs to complete before the start channel to keep the size of the short stroke. Set the end channel value to 1. When you scrub the time bar, you now have a short stroke that follows the brush stroke over time. As a tip, if you want to adjust the keyframes gesturally in the animation editor, make sure you change the tools mode from paint to select. Otherwise, nothing will happen when you try select keyframes with the cursor in the channel editor. So that's how you can animate a stroke in Flame 2018. It's great for this type of motion graphics, but it could also be used for a variety of other tasks, including wire removal, plate cleanup, and more. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2018 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.